Here we are. All right, so I tried a lot for like 2 days to get a PS5. Didn't really pan out, so Demon Souls is not happening for the foreseeable future. Because PlayStation 5s are functionally unobtainable right now. But hey, there's an expectation, there's a desire, there's a specific kind of game I'm trying to play right now, and I can't. So what do we fill that void with? Well, there's a whole, thankfully that particular franchise has an entire genre that spawned around it of the Souls likes. And so let's go to my Souls like list. And top of that list, most promising, potentially good one on the to-do list is probably Mortal Shell. But hey, at least we got to get through some of my backlog. I'm so behind. I'm behind by like 10 Souls likes, and I've played a lot of them anyway. What, let's see. Hold to dismiss. Okay. We can always change this over time. The heavy amount of front-loaded settings, none of which were looking version, I'm gonna point out. That's a good one to front load if you're gonna front load settings like that. Anyway. Seasonal content enabled. Hello. Subtitles scale. There are a lot of settings. Hide Ballista Zooka. What does that mean? What does that mean? Ballista Zooka controller sensitivity. What a fucking word to throw my way, the Ballista Zooka. Okay, let's do it. Now I'm curious. Well, that is a Dark Souls loading screen. Beyond the grip of the familiar, a threshold demands to be crossed. The mortal shells yearn for meeting, awaiting a glimpse of their true purpose. Well, I definitely look like somebody that's gonna have a happy ending and not gonna just be a character that is born miserable and dies miserable with nothing in between. Hello there. Was I supposed to get a sword somewhere? Are you coming at me? Harden. You've inherited the ability to harden your body. Hardening prevents harm from attacks, but is broken quickly upon taking physical damage. So it prevents harm, but only briefly. I'm a rock. Oh. Oh, he's done. A hallowed sword, a heavy sword with a hollow at its center. Photo mode. Whoop! That's what happens when you hit select. calm down a little bit. Oh, shells. Are those like the characters I can switch between or something? A heavy sword with a hollow at its center. This cumbersome sword appears broken or perhaps unfinished. A piston-like mechanism is buried deep inside. Is it a gun sword? Oh my god. Wait, did he catch the other side of the what? Instead of bringing the sword back around, he grabs the tip of it and swings the handle at his enemy. I don't know how reasonable that is, but that's what he do. You have harden. You may harden in most situations, even while attacking. Experiment with hardening at different times. Oh, I'm getting frame drops. Oh, that'll take some getting used to. I think there's a cooldown that's attached to it, whether you successfully blocked an attack or not. Ah. I'm mostly just getting my ass kicked. This is a weird system. Oh, right. So if you use it at all, even if you dismiss it and don't actually block an attack with it, then it's still, I mean, it's a core mechanic. Presumably, I have reason to want to use it. But it does, like, stop me dead in my tracks, which feels very strange. That said, I am struggling with the fact that he seems to not really get interrupted by anything I do. Like, that's one of the only... Hardening does seem like one of the only things that actually stuns him a bit. Oh god, you can't pause the game. Okay, they were requiring me to harden while attacking in order to stop. Okay, we're getting some stuttering here, so let's see. Let's maybe lock the frame rate. Indie mode? What? Indie mode. It just makes it look like a bunch of squares. That gives it like a stylized resolution. Alright, well that's cute. It does make the text a lot harder to read though. Yeah, that's a decent transition to show you what's happening. It's kind of funny. Let's see if I can find what's causing the stutter and get rid of that. Because obviously I'm completely fucked if the game keeps freezing mid-fight like that and skipping a few frames. A token which begets a connection to the mortal realm. The mortal token. We got like familiarity things. What does it actually do though? Use 10 more times to reveal further detail about this item. Use this item to reveal its effects. Well, that's a little fucking worrying, but okay. Next damage taken while hardened is converted to health. Ah. So you soak damage instead of taking it. This is my roll. If I double tap, does he roll? Yep. It's one of those games where you dash, then roll. There's been a few of those. Oh. Okay. I guess you're my first real enemy. Oh, did you take damage at all from that? He missed me completely. Oh, he has hardened. His name seems to just be an anagram of Harden. Yeah. Yep, shit. Yeah. Whoop. I'm not doing great at this game. I'm not getting the clearest openings of when I can attack, I suppose, without getting hit back. Even if I harden. Like, they emphasize this harden system really heavily, but then even if I use it, it doesn't necessarily create this giant opening that I want. Is it a meant to lose fight? Oh, it's one of those beginning of a Souls game fights that you will probably lose the first time. Cause yeah, you don't even have a heal. Well, I guess that's that. That was the end of our test. The end of the Harden tutorial has a boss fight named Hadron. All they did was move the R a little bit. Falgrim, a tower hums, where a muted dweller ruminates his fate. Well, now where the hell are we? Do I get from Nightmare Land to Nightmare Land via that each time? Some kind of like water worm thing? You can see him through me in certain parts of my body, like my armpits. Or earlier in that cutscene, my butt. Like my butt had a weird floaty chassis to it where like in some of the areas that are less detailed, you could see straight through it. You can see that in my armpit there. Wait, am I still just casually crawling? I don't think he's transitioned to climbing. Gravity's just nonsense here. So the combat will take some getting used to, or that was just an unusually hard one, but nothing I did seemed to stun the enemy particularly, but there also wasn't great openings. I was trying to find punishable openings where I could do any real damage, and I wasn't really finding them. Even the hardened mechanic, it's like, okay, I can stop the damage from one attack, but I have to like completely stop in my tracks for like a solid second. And then his recoil from getting hit by it, at best, opens him up to one fast attack, or if that, maybe not even that. But I need to figure out the flow better of like what they're intending for this and what they want from me. Hello, creepy eye. I can't seem to interact with you. There's just a mask with antlers sticking out here. Don't worry, I'm a statue. This is normal. Well, my health bar is tiny now after losing that. What are we heart beating? What's up? What's going on, game? Are you warning me not to inhabit unknown shell? Oh. So is that like my ghost form? I was gonna say, I'm already playing Hell Point. I don't know if I want another Souls-like where I spend the whole game as a weird, naked, like, white, plasticky dude. Still a familiar moveset. He just looks different. I'm assuming he'll be here in shells. Unknown shell. Undiscovered shell. That guy's got a hood. Looks like Altair. He looks like he's wearing a crown and a shoulder blade, shoulder pad. He's kind of indistinct. So we have like four characters you can play as, basically. I wonder if this is like the idea of applying like the loadouts that shooters have, but to your Souls-like style game, so you can hot swap between builds, basically, based on the situation. Could be an interesting option to set it apart. Welt cap flourishes where blood is spilled. Is that its respawn timer? It is, isn't it? There's a little circle that's slowly draining. So when it goes all the way back around, it must fill up. And come back. You can make your return trips. Yeah, so once again, we don't know what it does until... generates 30 health over 30 seconds. Got our life gems. They're just showing somebody's up in a hut. Might be my goal. There's also somebody walking around underneath. Glimpse of fragility. Glimpse into your shell when consumed. Alright, that time, after describing what it is, I'm still not entirely sure what it does. Oh, experience. Glimpse into your shell. But it says experience, so that's like the best indication we have so far of what it does, I guess. So that's probably how you level up your particular build. Because I guess I leveled them all up separately, right? Oh, fuck you, box. He attacked it like it insulted him. Can I open that one? These are also quick items, huh? A simple loot, remnant of tar, currency. Sure what I expected, honestly. He's not very good at it. He is wearing armor, admittedly. If I feel my familiarity with it, does he become competent at using it? Practice makes perfect. It doesn't even say, like, if it does anything. It's just, hey, if you keep using it, so you get better. Oh. Alright, now play the Last of Us theme. There's a poop cloud on me. Is it gone? I mean, this is a really funny mechanic to have in your game. It's amusing. I mean, I just crank it out right now. What's this thing do? It says it grants a minuscule amount of tar when consumed. I wonder if glimpse or tar is the more direct translation of souls in this game. Well, that time we just played the same one again. Oh, it's almost... That one's almost back. Yes, that's what the vision was of. If you're gonna show me that if you're gonna show me that camera thing that you just showed me, what was the point of the tablet? They both seem to enforce the same idea, which is like, hey, maybe check that spot out. What did I just hear? A lot of toads around. Friend or foe? Am I gonna slip and slide down this? I'm gonna go with foe. Hey, buddy. Ow! I didn't do shit. Did I do it in time? Ah. Okay, these frame drops need to be dealt with. I will put these settings on low if I have to. I don't know what's causing that. Sorry, buddy. Not that sorry. I'm basically never sorry. It's pretty much a lie just to make myself feel better. Sorry if I made you... Let's see. Turn down some blurs. Put the game in chill the fuck out mode. Just put it generally on medium. There. The game, as usual, when you turn the graphics down in a game, it looks practically identical anyway. Especially after YouTube processing and everything, so you guys will notice even less. Oh. Ah! But I just want to see those little, like, skips that are happening go the fuck away, because this is going to be a real problem. Intense situations, or, you know, every fight of the game. More tar spore. Are they not following me? Oh, deals 40 poison damage over 16. Oh, shit. Okay. I'm gonna need one of those welt caps to counteract that. Oh, wait, is it gonna do oh, it's healing slower than the damage is gonna kill me. Well, he's a statue now. Can I just go back in? Sup, I'm back. Alright, shell retrieved. A man is more than just a sleeve. Is he though? So far, I don't know about that man. So the bad news is that the poison cap that I took to test what it does more damage than the healing cap does. But the good news is, I apparently just got right the fuck back in the body anyway. Well, this is creepy. Hi. Friendo. Not friend. Not fr- Oh, God! Not friend. How do I get him off? Whoop! Alright, they do poison damage. Good news, class! We're gonna die! Okay. Whoop! Alright, he tried to eat me, but I was hard. Listen. This is gonna be a lot of- We're just gonna have to get this out of the way right up front and just accept there's gonna be a lot of euphemism going on. And double entendre with this, the fact that I harden. Let's just all accept that about this playthrough. And embrace it and enjoy it. Hello. You jumping at me? We doing this? He seems uncommitted. I'll help him out. Well, that's embarrassing. The glimpse of truth glows bright. Celebratory loot. Let's go. Yeah, the glimpse of truth. Okay, so you fill up, you've run out of slots eventually. Gotcha. Put you in the last one. One more time gives me more info. Okay. Ooh, that filled that up. My familiarity capped out immediately. Glimpse into your shell when consumed. What is glimpsing? Do I know what my shell is now? Is that what happened? Unknown shell. A man is more than just a sleeve. Half durability, stamina, and resolve. 5 out of 10 in all. He seems to be a well-rounded dude. Glimpses and tar are both currency on the screen. Shades none. This glimpse of truth glows bright. Grasped within the glimpse, there are multitudes, their bodies thread together, forming a single, indivisible being without a name. This nameless, formless creature speaks in all tongues. It speaks the bearer's name. It is burgeoning and unraveling all at once. The vision grants more questions than answers. Glimpse of futility. It's nearly opaque. We need more information for that one, but this one just went straight to full familiarity. For whatever reason. Tarspore gives me the tar currency, right? No, that does damage, okay. Because tar is also a currency, so that's a little confusing. But no, it's welt caps that heal you. Tar spores are gonna hurt me. But if I keep eating it, I gain familiarity. Oh no, completionism. I better hurt myself more for completionism's sake. So yeah, I'm aware there's a lot of branching paths that could have gone down before, so we're definitely backtracking. But first I want to see how far this goes. So they're giving me a lot of paths so far. Okay. The two fades to- I don't know if two separate fade to blacks was necessary for the transition. Whoa. This is familiar looking, isn't it? Yo, God! That didn't- that reached further than I expected it to, I guess. So that's what real death is like, apparently. I suppose I'm wondering why that death killed me, but the other one didn't. Are you a, so you're a bonfire? You're like a checkpoint? Or something? This game's got some stuff to figure out. Okay, so my glimpses appear to still be here, but my tar is gone. So I probably go back to my body to retrieve my tar, if it's anything like other games. That dude was aggressive. When do I get, like, any reliable healing? Is there any reliable healing? Is it just these very slow welt caps? I guess that dodge didn't work out. Oh, he went. He did not have a good outing. Just a long, deflating sound. Can I use the tar spore on an enemy instead of eating it? That's really the next question for me, I feel like. And can I escape through this tunnel before they get me? Or do they... Maybe they don't respawn. Because they're not here. Okay, so there's my body. It's like a statue. Can I get to it before this guy sees me? Okay, you just click on it real quick. Oh, okay, I thought he was gonna wake up and attack me. I was a little worried. Is anyone else gonna come after me, or are we good? Is it just me and you? Oh boy, he's got range. There we go. A no-hit fight. I didn't take a hit. We'll make progress. Some of this might be me being Souls game rusty because I'm not in the constant loop of playing like 5 playthroughs per year or whatever of Souls games now that we're in a lull. But it's also like I gotta get used to this particular game's rhythm. You do get certain Firelink shrine vibes from this area, don't you? With its own flavor, too. Oh, I thought you guys were NPCs, just having a chill time. Oh no, you poor man. You seem to just be a regular dude that is not ready for what's about to happen to you. Yep. Pumpkin's pretty great. Is it because it's Halloween? Seasonal content disabled. I don't know. It could be. It could definitely be that his hat is tied to him being near Halloween. We're past Halloween at this point, though. So if it's for that, it's lingering. Alright, here comes the jump test. Clicking right stick, clicking left stick, double tapping B, trigger. Alright, I'm not finding anything so far. I guess we can just check the real controls. Kick is X. That's good to know. But I don't... Unless I'm going too fast, I don't see jump. So until further notice, I'm gonna think there's no jumping. I'm trying to hit kick, but it's not doing anything. Maybe it only works with certain weapons or certain contexts. Or maybe they just meant like when I kicked open that chest. That guy was audio mixed like he was very close to me. Hey guys. Oh, you're gonna, you know, oh, thank you for noticing me one at a time. That's perfect. Oh. Can you make it up the sledge? Well, I feel like I cheated. Oh! I locked onto the wrong guy. You don't like that? Did I spook you? That's probably correct. Alright, well, I feel like I'm the dick now. All these people are just very directly afraid of me. It's like, oh no, this guy is some sort of nightmare man that obliterates us. What are we doing here? Why are we in these woods? Interesting, I don't think you're supposed to be able to go up that, but I guess you can go down it. It's like an ambush path. It was still pretty funny that their AI was practically turning off. Oh, does he see me? Oh, he sees me. Those guys are massively more dangerous than the randos. Could have gotten better. That's why I've got some of these, though. 30 health over 30 seconds. Let's maybe check my stats. Because true to form to games like this, this game's opaque as hell. And perhaps another example of that being, I don't know how much health I have. I think they're just gonna not give me any help there. I don't see a way to look at my stats. So I don't actually know what 30 health is necessarily, or because I don't know how much health I have. Because it's not numbered on the screen. But there also doesn't appear to be like a simple screen that's like, here's your dexterity and here's your health. Maybe we'll find it later, or maybe it just requires me to get familiarity with my guy. Somebody seems to be way better at playing a loot than me, which means they need to die. Oh, what was that sound? I didn't like that sound. Are we doing this? Are you stuck? You okay? I may be spotting a couple of places where this game could use a little polish. Like this poor guy. There you go, you did it, buddy. Yeah, thought I could hear one over here. Hey, buddy. Are there backstabs in this game? Oh, shit. Well, I completely fucked up. This is weird. I can, like, go kick their ass as my ghost. Let's get out of here. This is the strangest game. Okay, so I can kick their ass as the ghost, but at that point you die in one hit, so that's important to watch out for. Is that the guy who was playing the loot? Was it one of you guys? I was kind of holding out hope for meeting somebody I can talk to. Yeah? Was it you? Are you the loot man? The hardened mechanic definitely gives you a really obvious reaction to have against the big opening attack enemies often have. But there's, if nothing else, there's that. Huh? Flop, flop, flop. I was already saying I kind of feel like the bad guy, but then I come in here and, like, beautiful music's playing, and I'm like, better interrupt this and kill everyone in the room. I was expecting more of like a, ho, welcome, traveler. I will now practice my spooky laugh. Ha 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 ha. Hi. Do you see me? It's very convenient to me if you see me and come for me, because there's a lot of guys over there that are, nope. Which, what these guys got in their heads? Not gonna lie, this particular tangent I'm going on is way longer than I expected. They kind of wanted me to check out that one hut earlier. But I kind of just kept going. Because I was like, oh, what's on the side path? And it's like, apparently the entire game. Okay, I thought the other guy was maybe coming at me, but still only one of them. Can I get just one of you to come after me? Yes, it appears so. All right, I'm not near you, sir. There you go. Careful, careful. Oh, I just got way too close to the bad guy over there. I need to end this fight now. And nope, I didn't get him yet. He's not coming for me yet. Jump attack! Alright. I'm at least not constantly on the verge of death. Even though that small, regular enemy, the ones that get terrified of me regularly, one of them did a lot of damage to me earlier. I think I have both inferior and superior moonshine now. Might be a- whoop! Cool bats! What? This area is full of cool bats! It's very distracting. Look how fucking big they are. They're like people-sized. That's a lot of bat. That's the true Batman. The one that's just the size of a man. Another hole. Oh. Now I'm starting to wonder, was the music coming from them, or is the music guiding me through the woods like it's the Lost Woods from Zelda? Well. Oh! I would like to do a little harm reduction here. There's a lot of things coming at me right now. If we can get, like, just a few of you, please, that'd be nice. Oh, woo-hoo-hoo. Line of sight is important here. You guys are just lucky I don't have my own bow yet. Or you'd be in trubs. Huh. Oh. Oh, he's still alive. Hey, stop it. Is he still alive? Yes. But also plunging attacks exist. So, you know, a few discoveries were made here. Just shot that guy at the back of the head. I'm starting to wonder just how often this game will be unintentionally funny, because that's a really good one. Ah, there's a range problem for me here. Oh, he's not dead. Well, that was fucking costly. Taking one hit is a big health cost. It's like half the meter. Hello. You know, you really had a clear moment where it was time to run, and you didn't take it, and I guess I respect that. But not enough not to kill you. I will say I'm getting slightly worried about my ability to keep track of this environment and navigate it well. Because holy crap. It's actually getting pretty big and labyrinthine. That area looks populated. Okay, so that guy was the one playing music, I think. So as much as it feels like it's meant to have a larger meaning, I think it's just that. It is like a little characterization that's kind of interesting, just seeing like... it kind of humanizes your enemies, which actually makes you feel like you're even more of a dick, actually. But, I was kind of hoping for it to have like some sort of larger meaning throughout this entire level. Ooh. This looks like a... this feels like a like bait. It's such a straightaway that it feels weirdly like I'm in danger for going that way. What an environmental interaction to have. But yeah, I was kind of hoping that the loot music you're hearing in the distance would be continually this background detail throughout this level. It's kind of guiding you through it, and maybe it leads to like the main character or main boss of the zone. Because it does feel really evocative in a way that's like, it's a little surprising to find that it's just spent on random dudes and isn't like a really big deal the way that it kind of reads. I feel like it reads to the player. All right, well, let's close this one out. I'm in. Let's see where this game goes.